Danae Peart in the Vibe 105 studio talking to musical icon Miss Jully Black. For those who have never met Jully, don't know where you've been, but she's an actress, she's a musician, she's a songwriter, she is a motivational figure. She's here because she has a new album. It's her first full-length feature, and it's called Three Rocks and a Slingshot. We're getting into the introspective, finding out why she's calling it a diary entry. Miss Jully Black here for you, our Vibe audience. I wish I could follow your love. So we're excited about this album. Of course, it's in rotation here at Vibe.
Thank you.
And I want to go back a little. Mm-hmm. Let's start with the journey. 1990s, El Macumbo.
Oh gosh.
To 2022, Canada's Walk of Fame. What has this journey been like?
Wow, do we have enough time?
Listen.
20-something years. Wow, it's definitely been a journey.
Yeah.
I realized that there is actually no destination until my number is called and,
right.
and I leave the earth.
Right.
At one point I was like, okay, should I put out another album? This is my first full-length album in over 10 years. And so you have to live a life to tell a story. And I,
definitely.
After my mom passed, I wasn't sure what story I was still trying to tell.
Mm-hmm.
Did it make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Who am I without my mom?
Mm-hmm.
And it all came together that I had to really move fear out the way. That's the title of Three Rocks and a Slingshot,
mm-hmm.
an ode to David and Goliath.
Yes, of course.
Just recognizing that this little boy, you know, the tale is, he's like, I don't know, 8 years old or whatever, slaying this giant.
Yes.
Well, not with a gun, not with a cutlass.
No, no.
With three rocks and a slingshot. And so for me, I had to really load up my slingshot and be like, okay, fear, get out the way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, limiting beliefs, get out the way.
Mm-hmm.
Insecurities, get out the way.
Mm-hmm.
Lack of resource, get out the way.
Mm-hmm.
Just all the things and just go for it.
Took up all of my patience, put that ass on probation. No matter the occasion, ain't got no more relation with you. Ain't got no more relation with you.
It's interesting you say that because we wouldn't think strong Jully Black mm-hmm. needs to slay any Goliaths.
Right.
But you've been in the industry and the music industry is its own beast.
Right.
You've been on stage with the best of them.
Mm-hmm.
You've been in all the music videos that are of note in Canadian hip hop history as well. How come you still need to slay a Goliath?
Well, I look like me.
Mm.
I'm black in mm-hmm. a very white country.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just demographics. You know, but I'm very radical and bold and loving in my statement of, if I were Shania Twain, would I be starting over every time I put out an album?
Mm-hmm.
Or Serena Ryder, or, you know, Celine Dion, whomever.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like, why is it that black artists tend to have to campaign and canvas and start again,
reintroduce, reinvent, rebirth,
every single time.
Mm-hmm.
Where I'm friends with Jim Cuddy, for instance, Blue Rodeo. He's like a mentor in the business for me. People wouldn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
It's like Blue Rodeo doesn't have to lift a finger. Don't have to write a new song for the rest of their life.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Tom Cochran and all the rest of them.
Mm-hmm.
So what? And I'm a born, raised Canadian
mm-hmm.
of Jamaican descent. But what is it? Why is it not my birthright? Well, it is.
Mm-hmm.
And it was time for me to change my mindset first, because
mm-hmm.
if I'm thinking about what I don't have and the lack and the lack and the lack, I'm just gonna manifest more of that. That's my own personal beliefs.
Yeah. You've opened up an abundance mindset.
Yeah.
I keep loving you.
You now are letting us in to a world here.
Yeah.
This is snippets of Jully's diary. First of all, what the heck is going on in your diary, girl?
Wow. Yeah.
You know, but tell us why you describe it as that. Is it the catharsis of writing these songs? Is it the stories that are kind of hinted at in these songs? And we'll go into some of those later, but what is it why you describe it as a diary entry or some diary entries?
Well, I wanted everyone to know that these are my stories. So
mm-hmm.
being a songwriter and someone who's written for other people,
mm-hmm.
you don't know, is that Jully's life? Is that Destiny's Child's life? Is it whose life,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
But these songs
are your life.
Are female life. my life and my life as it was. So I wrote a lot of these songs from a place of healing, being in therapy, with my therapist, literally talking through things, working through the trauma, working through so many things, and being able to turn to the music now to be like, I gotta do a dump. I'm just gonna put it all on here.
So let's go into the album a little bit. There are multiple tracks that I love, and then there's some tracks that I love. So let's talk about the tracks that I love.
Okay.
So when you released the album, I said to you, the only thing I want more of is more of imaginary love.
I care about you. I'm not scared of you. You don't run for something really real. I really need to know.
Is this imaginary love? Imaginary trust? Imaginary everything that we have ever felt? It's just imaginary. Tell us a little bit about the story behind imaginary love.
Exactly that. I'm in a relationship. Doing all the things, feeling that I'm wifed up. You know what I'm saying? Family knows the youth.
Met people.
Right? But it's this bubble. It's just all in my imagination. And it was interesting because you just realize that as I live a woman's life, you know what I mean? And so many of us will be in these situationships, on relationships.
Oh,
and
speak to the people.
And you know, I'm pretty private, so most people don't know about my personal life in that way, but that's another thing why I wanted to put this album out in this way. You know, like those times where your man and girl's putting up pictures on Instagram, and you go up on the man page, and not a eyelash.
Not a sight.
You know what I mean? All those types of things. I'm like,
is this imaginary love?
It's imaginary love. Imaginary trust.
Imaginary trust. Listen, ooh, and you pour out your soul on that and the soulfulness on that. And then there are other tracks that I describe as bangers, you know, the club bangers that everybody's looking for. Can I dance to this? Can I drive with this? And then, of course, you pay homage to the land of your mom's birth.
That's right.
With the language.
That's right. She boxed me up when I was a kid if I even tried.
So we got Fufu Girl. She don't want you to come back to me. So tell us a little bit about the motivation behind that one. Because Vibe told me that's in heavy rotation over here.
Heaviest, good.
They love it. So tell me about Fufu Girl.
So let me tell you about Fufu Girl. So Fufu Girl, in fact, I was writing that for a friend of mine.
Okay.
I've been a Fufu Girl.
Okay.
You know, a lot of us have been a fufu girl.
Tell the truth.
So the thing is, I wrote it in the tense of speaking on behalf. She done.
Yes.
She done with you. So it's also my conscience telling me, look it, no matter with that again.
Yeah.
And also me. Imagine this. Your friend is going through the stuff. Imagine this scoop. I scoop my girl from behind me.
Yeah.
And it's me and the youth now.
Yes.
She done.
Yes.
Yeah. She done with you.
Yeah.
She not going back and forth with you no more.
All right.
She done with you.
Enough.
She not trying to bend over. She not trying to pay you no mind. She not trying to take your disrespect no more. It's just full confrontation. Yes. Not trying to be your bedroom pet no more.
No.
Catch them lyrics there.
Listen.
Not trying to beg for anybody, man. No. She found a way. Said she wouldn't leave, but she found a way. Right. That part was very personal.
Said she wouldn't leave.
Right.
But she found a way.
She found a way.
So is that the friends pulling her out, or she finds her confidence again?
Confidence.
Self-love again.
Self-love.
Mm-hmm.
Like the whole zero contact rule.
Mm-hmm.
Like this is about a narcissist in particular.
Yes.
And there's certain things where you have to, I said, sit on your hands. You gotta you wanna text or you wanna...
Yeah.
The routine.
Yes.
Right?
Break it up.
Break
it up all the way.
All the way. Dig up them roots.
So she's not trying to be a fufu gal.
No.
So we got that. So then we get hit with one of the bangers, but there's also some lessons in here.
Right.
I was taken aback because Mackie, her voice is on I Love It.
Yeah.
The bad boy song.
Yes.
Mighty like the young one, you know, I know you, but me not saying, you know, mighty, but think Mark can do a little something.
And anybody who knows Jully, she doesn't share a lot of her personal life, but we've been on a journey with you and Mackie, right?
Mm-hmm.
From you getting Mackie to love dogs.
Yes.
To you doing the, you know, letting us in
mm-hmm.
to those intimate moments when mom was sick
mm-hmm.
and you guys are reasoning.
Yeah.
And I'm assuming that the clip that we heard at the start of this song comes from one of those reasonings.
100%.
Listen.
100%. So my mom, you know, we're raised traditional where you don't really speak to your parents about certain things, sex, this, that. And then we got to a certain age. Mom got to a certain age.
Yes.
Where she did away with religion and she was focusing on relationship. Like she was raising her kids, relating to her kids in a certain way. Real, right? Yes. And so I remember I was talking to her. I record everything. I could do a whole compilation on mom's clips.
I could imagine.
And I was talking to her about sex and relationships and as a Christian, you know what I mean? I was like, mom, you know, this whole sex before marriage, even though that done long gone already. And she was talking about, no man, you have to sample. You have to make sure you sample. And then the whole thing about him not having mighty. That was her type of words.
Yes.
But, you know, he's got to be able to take care of you.
Do little something. Little something.
Listen. So the joke is, though, I forgot that we put that on the beginning of the track.
Oh.
So my producer and good friend of mine, Versace P, when we did the track, mm-hmm. I was like, maybe we should put featuring Buddy Almaki.
Yes.
Like, on the track listing.
Yes.
And I remember him saying, you know, nah. Mm-hmm. Just make it start. And I was like, you know what? That's the tag still.
Yes.
And we released the record. I listened to the whole thing, and it surprised me.
Right.
And I just kind of had a...
You had a moment, right?
And then, but I heard my laugh.
Yeah.
And I was like...
Yeah, when you cackled at the end, I'm like, this is not no new convo. These two been tearing it up in conversations,
yeah.
And it was precious.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure for you to have that experience.
Yeah.
To kind of segue, your mom mm-hmm. influenced you.
Yeah.
In many ways, like I remember when you did Caroline or Change, you spoke about
my God
the impact. Of being able to represent what your mom really means
mm-hmm.
in a role like that. And now you have the album and you get to put her voice there. Yeah. And I tell people all the time, when you see women cut their hair, especially black women cut their hair,
should I be looking at you guys right?
Something yeah. is about to go down. Something's up, something's changing.
Mm-hmm.
How has this transition been for you from Jully with mom to Jully with mom in another way?
Ooh, that's deep. Jully with mom. I remember when she was basically about to pass away days before, and she was still there. And I used to say to her, like, okay, mom, you know, pray for me. And she would just softly say, no, you can pray for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you have the same power I have.
Mm-hmm.
And she would just leave these nuggets. You know, I said, mom, she said to me, Jew, do you want to be a mom or do you want to have a baby?
Mm.
I said, I want to be a mom. She said, we have your whole life. So many kids need love.
Okay.
Don't make nobody pressure you.
Mm-hmm.
All these things, she just leave. This woman just who pouring. Delivered 9 kids, you know.
Yeah.
She loved having kids. That's
yeah.
her, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And fostered and all the things.
Yeah. But she's pouring in.
Pouring in.
The strength that you're going to have to call upon.
Right. And actually removing this heavy, I was carrying this armor, this cultural armor, this heaviness of what I thought I had to be and do and all the things,
mm-hmm.
and not enjoying the fruits of my labor. It was always like, what's next?
Mm-hmm.
What's next?
Mm-hmm.
So as mom transitioned and I had time to just kind of think, mm-hmm. it made me go way back to like rallying and getting nominated for a Juno in like 99. And it's just kind of going through the list of things that were already, the real journey,
mm-hmm.
you know, as I'm also writing a book. But mom, and then mom not being here, I'm going to use a term that she used to say, and other people say in the Caribbean culture, don't make your angels get fat.
Okay.
Do not make
give
your angels.
Work.
Give them work for them. So I call it Heaven's Hallway. I wrote a chapter in my book called Heaven's Hallway, and that's what it is. I'm on the regular. Like, mom, I have a petition.
Mm-hmm.
I know God has a lot of applicants.
Mm-hmm.
I need you to take this one. And run it down
bring
the hallway.
Bring it straight,
knock the door and put it on top of the pile.
Yes.
You know, and it's those audible, different style of prayers
yes.
Like, I have someone working for me, man. Okay. In a way. But what had to happen first was a lot of forgiveness. Mm-hmm. Forgiveness of myself first and mm-hmm. others. Mm-hmm. And really understanding that what's for me won't miss me. Mm-hmm. And my mom, all my mom's saying, pride not have no feeling. Don't let your pride get in the way. Mm-hmm. This is why when you sent me, I sent you the thing, you sent me the message. I was like, yo, I want to get on the show. I want to talk about it. Mm-hmm. The Jully of the past coming from the system, mm-hmm. the industry, mm-hmm. who's the publicist that's mm-hmm. going to do this mm-hmm. and who's going to drive me and da 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 da. Mm-hmm. Pandemic changed everything. Social media, all of them people out there are my brothers and sisters, and you're going to get all of me.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's go.
Let's go. I wish I could follow your love. I wish I could.
As we wind down, mm-hmm. you hinted at something that you're writing your book.
I am.
And I'm curious, what else is in the dream for Jully now? Because, listen, you can check off a bunch of boxes, Jully.
Yeah.
Iconic, you've done theater, you've done movies, you're doing this album launch, you're doing it.
Mm.
What's next in the dream? What does David want? From Goliath. Let's state something out into the universe here. Because I heard you say on one of your lives, why not you?
Right.
Doing the big
arenas.
Arenas.
Arenas. Sell out Rogers Center, sell out Air Canada Center, sell out Madison Square, Bell Center in Montreal. All the things, arenas. And I'm going to say this, and it's all from a place of love. Not since, I don't know, maybe Deborah, but it's all black men as far as urban music that's doing the arena.
That we've let through the gates. Yes.
That we've let through the gates. The Drake, The Weeknd, the Tory Lanez, whatever, blah, 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 as far as this generation. Like, yes. What? What?
Yeah.
No, man. Add Tamia. Add Deborah. Yes. Add Divine. Add Krisha. Add Keisha. Come true.
Time now.
It's time.
So Jully, I just want to say it's always a pleasure to sit with you, always a pleasure to talk to you.
Thank you.
And you have our full support as usual.
Thank
and
you.
Continuing. And since you've put it out there, we're looking forward to buying our tickets to the big shows.
Yes.
With Jully as the headliner.
Yeah.
And she said it. She has a bridge and she's going to bring others with her.
100%.
So we're looking forward to that. Thank you, Jully Black.
Thank you. Do for your baby, for the-